Right now, I'm in the history-filled eternal city of Rome. And trust me, it feels like I just walked into a grand life-sized history book. Now, here's the thing. I'm going to be traveling through Europe for the next 35 days, and that means that I kind of have to keep things on a little bit of a budget. So the goal for today's video is to show you guys how you can roam on a budget. Get it? Roam on a budget. Good morning, guys, from my first official day here in Rome. I am so excited to be here, and look around me. I already feel like I stepped back in time. So I landed here last evening, and my first money saving hack was to use the Leonardo Express, which is the train from the airport to the main train station here in Rome. It cost me 18 euros, and from there I took a 5-minute walk to my accommodation. So in order to keep costs low, I'm staying in a hostel called the Beehive Hostel, and it cost me about 30 euros a night, and it's actually quite nice. I'm staying in a 6-bedroom dorm. It has super clean beds and has lockers to keep my stuff safe, which makes me super happy. Just a short walk away from my hostel, I found this cafe and I've ordered a pastry and a cappuccino, like the Romans do.
It's so good, sweet on the outside, got that chocolate on the inside.
That is probably some of the best cappuccino I have ever had. 1.5 euros later on a bus, and I've made it to Piazza Novana. The theme of this video is to be on a budget, and so I'm looking for as many free things as possible to do. This here is one of them. Piazza Novana is in the center of Rome and is one of the most beautiful squares. So this place once used to be a stadium, and that's why it has a shape of a rectangle. It's home to some very important and very beautiful sculptural sites. Sculptural sites, that sounds weird to say. So this right over here is the Fountain of the Four Rivers, and it's been topped with the obelisk of Domitian. Through a quick Google search, Domitian was the emperor of Rome during AD 81 to 96. He had a fascination with Egyptian art, so this fountain is basically a mix of Roman sculptures and Egyptian artwork. Thank you, Wikipedia. And right next to this fountain is this beautiful church called Saint Anganis. If you're coming to the piazza, you have to enter that church. It's funny, there's a lot of tourists, but nobody really enters the church, and it's free to enter. The artwork inside is so beautiful and intricate. I'm mind blown. And a short 5-minute walk later, I've now made it to the Pantheon. This beautiful building, the Pantheon, was once a Roman temple until 609 AD, and then after that it was turned into a Catholic church. And since it's still being used as a church, it's one of the best preserved Roman ancient buildings. So this dome over here is super unique. It has that large hole there which is open to the world. You can see a beam of sun rays. During the rainy season, the water does fall straight through, and there's some holes for drainage. And something super cool about this dome is it's the largest unreinforced concrete dome in the world. A temple built for Roman gods. How beautiful are thee? One of the coolest things about Rome is that all the main sites are somewhat close to each other in the historic center, and so it's easy to get to them by walking, and it's a great way to experience the city. And what I really love is the narrow streets all lined with cobblestone. That being said, you also want to make sure you're wearing very comfortable shoes.
Almost everywhere you look in Rome, you'll see these little cars.
It must be so convenient getting around with those, because you can park easily and you can get through the narrow streets in a tiny cute little vehicle. Rome is a city of seven hills, and right now I'm making my way up one of the most important, which is called the Capitoline Hill. Here lies the Piazza del Campidoglio. I'm surprised I got that right. It was one of the first ever modern squares, which was designed by the famous Michelangelo. What's really interesting is, despite how beautiful this place is, it's not that busy. There's just a couple of crowds here and there.
This bird has literally hung out there for like the last hour,
just posing for people. So when you walk down to the back of the square, this view is incredible. And the crazy thing is, there's not many people here. So I got this all to myself. And the best part, it's free. So you're probably wondering, Rajveer, it's hot, it's summer, and I have to keep spending money on water. Well, luckily in Rome,
You can find fountains like this that have flowing water.
And it's all clean. So if you pick a bottle, and now you have yourself some very cold, fresh and clean water. Whew. All that free sightseeing has really worked up an appetite. Luckily, Rome has so many places where you can eat from. But here's a money-saving hack. Make sure you don't eat at a restaurant that's close to the touristy sites. If you take a little bit of a walk away from the touristy sites, 5 minutes to 8 minutes, you'll find places that are more authentic. I got a panini for 5 euros, which is way cheaper than what I would get it for at the tourist site. It's got some cheese in there. It's got a little bit of ham, some lettuce. It's so good.
Very fast.
Grazie.
Prego. Next up.
You can't come to Rome and not get a gelato. So this is a medium size for 4 euros 50. I probably spent a bit too much. If I spent 3.50, I would have gotten a smaller one. And yeah, clearly this is huge. This is awesome. Real quick, this video has been sponsored by Surfshark, which provide the best VPN on the internet. VPN stands for Virtual Private Network, and it basically takes all the data that's moving between your computer and the internet and encrypts it so that hackers can't get their hands on it. This data could be sensitive information such as passwords, bank account information, or even credit cards. As a traveler who's been consistently using public Wi-Fi, I've been using Surfshark to keep myself safe from hackers who may want to steal my data. Not only is a VPN great for your online safety, but it also has other benefits. For example, the one that benefits me most is virtually changing my location so that I can access content that wouldn't be available in my location. For example, the time when I was in Brussels and I couldn't access Big Bang Theory on Netflix. If you want to keep yourself safe online, then I highly recommend Surfshark. It's the only VPN on the internet that allows you to use unlimited devices on just one account. So if you want to try out Surfshark for yourself and get the amazing benefits of using a great VPN, then follow the link below and use the code AdventureSingh to get 83% off, 3 extra free months, and their antivirus for free. With that, let's get back into the video. And now I welcome you to the most epic fountain in the entire world. So, legend has it, you take a coin, you throw it with your left hand over your right shoulder, and that means you'll come back to Rome again in the future. Legend also has it, if you throw 2 coins, then you come back with the love of your life. Unfortunately, I'm on a budget.
So because of all the coin throwing, there's thousands and thousands of euros in the water.
All those euros are collected and they're used to maintain the fountain. The excess is donated to charity. And with that, there's loads of people, so it's time to go. One of the best ways to get around the city is by getting this. So this is a 100-minute ticket. It costs 1 euro 30 cents. And basically with it, you have 100 minutes to use a train, use a bus. And if you're like me, then within those 100 minutes, you can kind of like get to a destination, look at it quickly, and then take a bus to the next destination. Man, I am just loving this city. So the sun is setting, or I think it's about to set. I'm not even sure anymore. It's currently 7:30 p.m. and the sun is still blazing.
So that right there is the time the sun is going to set.
I've never experienced that in my life. Wow. But this is so beautiful. I'm actually making my way to a place called Trastevere. So Trastevere is this cute neighborhood here in Rome that's known to have some of the best restaurants, authentic and cheap. This place is a vibe. Because of all that money we've saved, I'm gonna be treating myself tonight for dinner. So we're looking to spend maybe 15 euros on a meal. You guys, after 30 minutes of waiting in line, first of all, I made some new friends.
Hey.
You guys, look at this. This is a seafood spaghetti and it was just 12 euros. So you got mussels, prawns, and spaghetti. I love Rome. Mwah. And finally, we're gonna end off the night with some tiramisu.
I think the only way you could top
it's like this,
is
like this.
It's a trifle.
Mm.
Good morning, guys, and welcome to day two from here in Rome. And right now, I'm heading into the Colosseum. This is the first place where I had to pay for entry. I had to book a ticket online, mainly because I wanted to skip the lines and I wanted to make sure that I actually am able to get into the Colosseum. It costed me €2 extra. I paid €18 instead of €16, which you pay at the gate. Basically stood in line for like 2 minutes and now we're heading in. And welcome to the great and largest amphitheater of entertainment.
Are you not entertained?
Back in the olden days, you can guess, there was no YouTube, there was no The Adventure Singh channel, there was no social media, and so what people turned to for entertainment was watching battles of gladiators fighting to the death. That's why this Colosseum was built. The gladiators that were chosen to fight to the death were prisoners of war, criminals. So if two gladiators were facing each other and one kind of won, the other could either ask for mercy or was killed. And that was decided by the emperor. Welcome to the Roman times. You guys, from what I've seen on the internet, I can't believe I'm actually walking through the Colosseum with like almost nobody around.
This whole area right over here used to be the arena.
So all the preparations used to take place underground and gladiators or animals would randomly just be brought up through some system that had been built and would appear onto the arena during the fight. To think all this was built way back in the day. Something really impressive that I was reading was that this place would easily fill up 50,000 people in just 15 minutes because of how smartly it was built. So after the Colosseum, I'm passing some awesome structures over here and making my way to the Roman Forum, which is also part of the ticket that I bought, which is not bad if you're on a budget. I am thoroughly enjoying myself walking back in time, seeing the way the Romans used to live. So the Roman Forum used to be a place of social, political, and religious gathering. Basically, your olden age mall. All the Romans used to hang out here. I walked 20 minutes away from the Colosseum to a place called Daba Feto and had a pizza marinara with a house wine, all for just €7. And then just next to it was a gelato shop with some amazing gelato for just €2.50. I love Rome. It's such a charming city. And right now I'm at Piazza de España, where you have the great Spanish steps that are the widest steps in the entire world. And I'll be honest with you guys, I am extremely tired, especially after that pizza and the gelato. I feel like sleeping, but the free budget travel must go on. And so we're gonna go up these steps just to say that I went up the greatest steps in the world. Oh, that feels good. This morning, I've made my way to the Vatican City, which is the smallest independent state in the entire world, and it's surrounded by Rome. It's a beautiful city. So you have a small square and it's surrounded by the Vatican Museum and the St. Peter's Basilica, which that is free to enter. So we're going to go to the church. There's a lot of tourists here and we'll have to stand in a very long line to get into the church. This is what happens when you're on a budget. You can't get skip the line tickets, which I should have. But for the sake of this video, I'm gonna go and stand in line. You can be on a budget, but there's just some things that are not worth it. Standing in that line is not worth it, especially in this blazing sun, unless you come earlier in the morning. So the St. Peter's Basilica is the largest church in the entire world. So you have to wear your mask while inside. And I've just entered the church. Oh my God, this church is a work of art. My breath has been taken away. I am in so much awe. Wow. This church also has the tallest dome in the world, and you can actually go to the top of it to see a beautiful view of the Vatican City. Now, to go to the top, it costs €10 to go up 521 steps, or you can pay €8, use an elevator, and then go up 320 steps. I'm gonna choose the stairs route. €2 saved is €2 I can spend on food. And so it begins. This is a serious leg workout. The stairway keeps getting narrower and narrower. This is not something you want to do if you're claustrophobic. Oh my God. When will this end? That was long and nerve-wracking and all sorts of claustrophobic. I can't even say that word right. That right there is the view of the Vatican City. Totally worth the steps. You guys, it's been an incredible time exploring Rome and eating my way through it. So I'm ending off my day here in one of the most authentic ways possible at the bank of River Tiber, and I'm waiting for the sun to set. I'm just enjoying this beautiful sight. I had a gelato. So with that, I'm gonna end this video here. I hope you guys learned a little bit about what a budget trip in Rome would look like. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to hit that like button. If you're new here, consider subscribing, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.